Hello friends, let's move to the next formula to find particular integral for trigonometric functions. Whenever our function f of x is trigonometric, that is cos ax or sin ax, we can find value of particular integral by using this formula. So first we consider our trigonometric function will be cos ax. So we first take derivative of cos ax. So this derivative will be a times minus sin ax. Similarly, if we take second order derivative of cos ax, so this derivative will be minus a as it is. Derivative of sin ax will be a into cos ax. So just observe, for even powers we are getting the same function cos ax. So without loss of generality, if we have function in terms of d square, when operated on cos ax, we get same kind of expression in terms of minus a square for trigonometric function cos ax. Then if we adjust the terms, then 1 upon phi of d square into cos ax will be same as 1 upon phi of minus a square into cos ax. So we can call this as our shortcut formula to find particular integral for trigonometric function. So we can remember this as, whenever our f of x is trigonometric, that is cos ax, we replace d square from auxiliary equation by minus a square, where a is coefficient of x in the trigonometric function. So here remember one important rule: we have to take minus times a square, where a is taken from coefficient of x in the trigonometric function. So this term has to be negative every time. And the formula is, replace d square by minus a square. We are not replacing d by some square root of minus a square. It is not possible. So use this formula in this way. Same is the case with, if my function f of x is sin ax, we can apply the same logic. Derivative of sin ax is a times cos ax. Then second order derivative of sin ax will be a into derivative of cos is minus a times sin ax. So second order derivative of sin ax will be in terms of sin ax only. So if we operate some polynomial in terms of d square on sin ax, we get similar type of polynomial in terms of minus a square. So rearranging the terms, we get a similar kind of shortcut formula for sin ax as well. Whenever 1 upon phi of d square is operated on sin ax, we just need to replace d square by minus a square for the same trigonometric function sin ax, provided that value of this phi of minus a square is not equal to 0. If this becomes 0, then our solution does not exist. So this is shortcut formula. So for trigonometric function, we just need to remember, replace d square by minus a square. And if we go for case of failure, if phi of minus a square becomes 0, then we first consider the auxiliary equation in terms of d square, then take derivative of d square, auxiliary equation with respect to d, and then here we replace d square by minus a square. We use the same formula again and check whether this value is non-zero. If phi of minus a square is not equal to 0, then the required particular integral will be, since we differentiated once, so it will be x into 1 upon phi dash of minus a square into the same trigonometric function, whether it is sin ax or cos ax. This trigonometric function will be same as our given original f of x. Fine. So this will be the case. Again, condition will be this phi dash of minus a square is not equal to 0. So we'll take one example. Suppose our auxiliary equation is d square plus 2d plus 1 y is equal to sine 2x. So here we can find complementary function from the auxiliary equation itself. Now we go for particular integral directly. So for calculating particular integral, here f of x is sine 2x, means value for a is equal to 2. This implies value of minus a square will be minus 4, and our formula will be replace d square by minus 4. Fine. Therefore, the required particular integral is, we operate d square plus 2d plus 1 on the trigonometric function sine 2x. By using shortcut method formula, we have to replace d square by minus 4. So we replace it. So it is equal to minus 4 plus 2 times d. Since there is no term containing d square, so we keep the same trigonometric function as it is. Now we simplify. It is equal to 1 upon 2 times d minus 3 into sine 2x. Now to remove this d from the expression, we have to bring d square. So what we do, we multiply numerator by the conjugate of denominator so that we rationalize it and bring d square in the denominator. So this 2d plus 3 as it is, and denominator term will be a minus b into a plus b is a square minus b square into the same trigonometric function. Now here we obtain d square in the denominator, so we replace d square by minus a square. So it is equal to 2 times d plus 3 into, so what will be the value? Replace d square by minus 4. Minus 4 into 4 will be minus 16. So the denominator term will be minus 25 into sine 2 times x. So if you take that minus 1 by 25 outside, now we take this sine 2x and multiply to the bracket 2d plus 3. So take derivative of sine. So derivative of sine will be 2 times, so that is 4 times cos 2x plus 3 times sine 2x. So this will be the required particular integral for the given trigonometric function. Fine. So in this way we can find complementary function for the given linear differential equation. Let's take another example where case of failure may arise. So here important part is, try to remember, we need to replace d square only, not the term containing t. So let's take d cube plus 4 times d into y is equal to cos 2 times x. So we find particular integral where f of x is equal to cos 2x. Here value for a is equal to 2. Again we need to replace d square by minus a square, and here minus a square will be minus 4. So we take auxiliary equation. So phi of b, since our trigonometric function is d square, so we take original auxiliary equation as it is. So if you take d common, so this will be d square plus 4. Now we check whether there exists case of failure or not. If you replace d square by minus 4, so this value is equal to 0, means we are getting case of failure. So So we differentiate auxiliary equation with respect to b. So this will be 3 times b square plus 4. Now we replace b square by minus 4 here. So what will be this value? So minus 4 into 3. Sorry. So that will be minus 12 plus 4, which is equal to minus 8. Now this value is non-zero. So we got non-zero value after taking first derivative. Therefore, the required value for particular integral is, since we have taken first order derivative, so we take 1x into 1 upon non-zero value into the trigonometric function as it is, that is cos 2x. So this will be the required value of particular integral. So there may be examples in competitive exams like GATE, where you need to find value for particular integral within very short amount of time. So you just need to remember this formula for calculating particular integral within no time. Okay, remember, for trigonometric function we are expected to replace d square of the even powers of terms only. Okay, thank you.